Thank you. family and friends, please be seated. Seniors, if you'd like to remove your masks, you may do so now. And seniors, please be seated. Board members, graduates, parents, guests, alumni, and employees, welcome to the commencement of the class of 2021. I do have to say how wonderful it is to see you all here today, gathered in person. And there were times when we weren't quite sure that we would make it here today. Some of you may know that I spent my most routine this entire year was to stay with the seventh graders for their lunch. And in the fall, I would be out on the middle school field and I'd be looking around, and I heard the buzzing just a minute ago. I'd be looking around and there'd be crows that would be circling and there'd be hawks that would be circling, and I was kind of curious to watch that. And then I'd look down and watch the seventh graders eat. Food going everywhere. And then I knew what those crows were up to. And we got to the winter, right? And the low point of the COVID year. And we hung on at Cary Academy. We still managed to hobble through in orange mode. But I did look up in the middle of the winter, and the crows and the hawk were replaced by vultures circling above. And I wondered if that was a little foreshadowing on what the rest of the year was going to entail. But I knew that these seniors were going to be okay. They were far too big for those vultures. But I have to say, I worried about our sixth graders having lunch out on the quad there. But I would like to thank all of you, our employees, and especially our seniors for your leadership this year. You set an example for all of us and made such a successful year possible. And there are many lessons that we could draw from these past 15 months. And I suspect that we will be unpacking these lessons for many years to come. But in thinking about this particular moment, sending off the class of 2021, I was drawn to a quote from the author and behavioral psychologist Steve Maraboli, who said, "Life doesn't get any easier or more forgiving. We get stronger and more resilient." And did we ever this past year? And with that, it gives me great pleasure to welcome family and friends to your commencement ceremony. At this time, I'd like to introduce our board of directors. Independent schools like Cary Academy are governed by boards who accept the responsibility for the school's long-term success. And Cary Academy's board is a group of highly respected community leaders. They model excellence in their careers, service, and commitment to our school. As I list the names of our board members in attendance today, I'd like to ask them to stand when introduced. And at the end, would you please join me in thanking them with a round of applause? And good night. Jim Goodnight, Trudy Bate, Joan Davis, Kim Eamon, Sandra Gutierrez, Manju Kakare, Greg Sanchez, Monica Udell, and Jennifer Weiss. We will now hear from some very special individuals. All of the students speaking today share the honor of having been selected by their classmates. Emily Zen will present a special thank you from the class of 2021.
Superheroes are everywhere. in movies, TV, and in books. But superheroes aren't just fictional characters. I like to think that they exist in our everyday lives. They're among us. Our parents are our real-life superheroes, who have many powers. One superpower is knowing the correct answer for everything. I don't really know how you guys do it. When I was younger, I would question why I couldn't microwave aluminum. My parents told me it's going to catch on fire, and sure enough, they were right. They also have the uncanny ability to know where everything is located. My mom can detect a missing charger, sock, or earring from about a mile away. She just does it. But I figured once I reached 18, an invisible switch would flicker on, and suddenly I would be just as wise and knowledgeable as my parents. However, after recently turning 18 and in the very early stages of adulting, I can tell you that I still have a lot to learn from my parents, and not much has changed. However, I do like to think that turning 18 has brought me some newfound wisdom. I have a new appreciation for my parents. I've realized that this wise and dependable adult I hope to become manifests in how my parents have cared for me for the past 18 years. But after sitting down to think about how to adequately express in words my gratitude to my parents, to all the parents out there, to thank you for your endless answers, wise words, and thoughtful comments, I realized that adulthood isn't so much a threshold to cross, but a choice to make. You all choose to make the sacrifices that you do. And for that, we thank you. We thank you for all those long nights, tear-filled dinners, and the unconditional support that allows us all to stand here today and receive our high school diplomas. As we graduate today, we are more aware than ever of the love and support you have given us to ensure our happiness, well-being, and success. But we know the journey doesn't end here. As the class of 2021 transitions into adulthood, our greatest hope is that we can be a little bit of the superheroes that you are to us. Class of 2021, please give your letter to your parents after the ceremony. Thank you.
The senior class has selected two student speakers. We will first hear from Armida Jamshadi, and then followed by Vibhav Nandagiri.
I would like to say cheers to Lincoln and Iran. You guys have support. Well, seniors, we finally made it. Today marks the monumental stride we take as we celebrate the triumph we've dedicated so much of our whole selves to, while also starting the next chapter as individuals, dare I say, as adults. We commenced our freshman year with a once-in-a-century total solar eclipse, happily sitting across the pristinely green quad, marveling up at the sun with our 3D looking glasses. It amazes me that on that August afternoon, we had absolutely no idea what would come of the next 4 years. The resounding relationships we would build, the catastrophic challenges we would confront, the struggle fests and celebrations and pure joy that would reward us at the end on this day. We absorbed a lot, ethically, socially, academically, and I wanted to reminisce on what I believe to have snowballed into our class's biggest takeaways of high school. So I decided to compile a list of four things we have demonstrated understanding of over these past 4 years. Firstly, though, I wanted to acknowledge some of the other stuff we've learned. We've learned a great appreciation for spoons. We've learned how to postpone beach trips and cancel prom. And we learned Rick, rationing ice cream. And you can't forget, we learned how to win at social. Starting off with lesson number one is the importance of horrendously hilarious hallmarks, or what Mr. Rushing calls type 2 fun. I think the perfect way to explain type 2 fun is to take a trip down memory lane to the freshman year outdoors discovery term. No, Mr. Rushing did not go on this trip, and that was the exact problem. 3 days and a lot of miles into our 5-day hike. All of our food fell into the river, and as you can imagine, we suffered pretty badly those next 48 hours. Yet, in retrospect, it made my freshman year worthwhile. That's exactly what type 2 fun is. Pretty horrendous in the moment, but stomach achingly hilarious when you look back on it. Teachers have intentionally implemented type 2 fun in their classes. The words 1.8, Macbeth, French Revolution, Mr. O'Shell's science class, and A Tale of Two Cities will forever stick with us because they were the most challenging parts of our CA experience, yet they were so memorable because those are the times we broke down and rebuilt our resilience to evolve into stronger students. That brings me to lesson 2, survive and shine. In other words, we adapt to change and then thrive in the midst of it. Freshman year was obviously different, but we've killed it since then. Some of us hiked 46 miles to see the granite towers in Patagonia. Others of us designed an app for students to navigate sex education and wrote and published research papers studying exercise science. The spectacular slimers and the creative crochets and the pristine plates and the violinist volunteers. To say we've overcome our transition into the upper school would be an incredible understatement, as we fiercely demonstrated through our various and profound successes. Not only have we exemplified our strength through the adjustment of the upper school, but even through the pandemic. Some of us grew passionate about the Black Lives Matter movement and started anti-racism projects and designed merchandise to raise money for the organization. Others of us developed businesses selling climate change apparel and marketing packages for smaller startups. And these things are just a scratch of the passion, dedication, and drive this class holds. Seniors, our optimism and fortitude are rare, or dare I say, unprecedented. It's not just about our explicit accomplishments, though. Here we have risks, rewards, and ruins. Lesson number 3 encompasses the risks we've taken that were sometimes rewarded and other times ensued by failure. I'll start with our senior rock. Maybe using paint that could be washed away by a light drizzle wasn't the best idea. Or running from triathlon star Madam Jones across the quad while she tries to fork you. There are stories that don't end up on the CA Spoon Instagram, though. By the way, go follow if you don't already, because the games continue. Some of us became athletic superstars and broke track and swimming records because we tried out a new technique. Others of us took a chance and effectively had musical breakthroughs. Socially, we've even upheld the expectation that the senior class becomes closer because we've branched out of our own circles, and I mean closer than 6 feet apart, at least spoon's length. That brings me to my last point, the forever friendships we've built with each other. Through the horrendously hilarious hallmarks, surviving and shining, risks, rewards, and ruins, through these past 4 and 7 years, and through literal events too. We can't forget about Camp Skeleton and the entire exchange trip program, Powderpuff Games and the ski trip that are all fundamental parts of these tender memories we built with one another. So, seniors, I hope you'll join me in remembering these lessons that the Academy has taught our class. Horrendously hilarious hallmarks, surviving and shining, risks, rewards, and ruins, and forever friendships. We commenced our freshman year with a once-in-a-century total solar eclipse, and here we commence the next chapter of our lives with a once-in-a-century pandemic, still happily sitting across the green grass, yet this time we look up at what the future holds. Some of us will go here, others of us will go there, but all of us will be Cary Academy's class of 2021. Congratulations, seniors. Thank you.
Today are 110 of the finest time travelers you will ever meet. Let me explain. I'd like you all to take a moment and imagine your life 5 years from now. Friends and family, faculty, feel free to join in as well. All right, now think ahead 10 years.
All right, now go back to your first day at Cary Academy, whether it was in the middle school or the upper school. I'm sure it was a whole family affair, so I'd like everyone in the audience to consider, where were you 7 years ago today, or perhaps four? What was going on in your mind? I'd like to congratulate you all. You've just traveled through time in your minds. I know, there was no 1981 DeLorean with those gull-wing doors, but unfortunately, the Center for Math and Science drained all of our funds. Now, I'd like to dig into this concept of mental time traveling a little bit deeper. How did it feel when you traveled to your past? For me, and I assume for a lot of us out here, it probably feels neat, packaged and compartmentalized into boxes somewhere in the back of our brain. There might be regrets and what-ifs, but the vast majority of our memories are wrapped up in the comfort of knowing how things panned out. And then there's the turbulent and uncertain flight to the future. Hope and fear, the daunting prospect of realizing dreams you don't even have yet. One thing that we can all agree on is that the future is not at all set in stone. Case in point, it doesn't matter if they've been with you through all of your 7 years, through the highs, the lows, the awkward phases, and the hours upon hours of late night conversations. One day you wake up and Skype for Business is gone, rendered powerless to the authoritarian force of Teams. You may be wiped from the Microsoft suite, but you will forever remain in our hearts. Mental time traveling is simply a part of the human manual, something that virtually all of us possess at birth. So what makes this group so good at it? Well, let's consider the future once more. Uncertainty is often seen as this taboo word, something to be avoided at all costs. I'd argue otherwise. Because you see, true progress comes from uncertainty. It's the act of taking that leap into uncharted waters that yields the creativity necessary to alter the course of scientific inquiry, to truly reckon with history and change a society. And the class of 2021 takes such leaps daily. We possess the ingenuity to launch international slime enterprises and manage a thriving crocheting and fiber arts company. We act on probing questions into the fundamental nature of physics and conduct complex experiments testing the efficacy of antacids. So, Tums is apparently a better bang for your buck if you all didn't know. That was for my advanced chem students here. Through it all, we managed to win state championships, make all-national choirs, bands, and orchestras, sweep science Olympiad events, carry speech and debate tournaments, and continue a 24-year undefeated streak with the football team. Now, quad F-ball is a whole other story, but we'll save that for another day. To top it all off, not only are we the most accomplished class to ever graduate CA, but we are also the most attractive. Never forget that. We have a legacy here, whether we chose to have it or not. We are the senior class who waded our way through the murky waters of a pandemic. With gusto, we embarked on our exchange trips only to end up being the last grade ever to experience them, as of now. Our mark on the upper school was so great, in fact, that they had no choice but to remodel the whole building now that we're leaving. Legacy is a two-way street, however. The imprint of a CA education is now upon us, hopefully for the better. Over the years, the faculty and staff have nourished us with thoughtful conversations, timely lessons, great food, and a campus so beautiful that our college visits were just that slight bit more underwhelming. In them, we have found mentors and friends, people willing to show us love, even if it was occasionally of a tougher kind. They've given us the tools and the support to push the limits of our work ethic. They've reinforced the idea that we are not too young to make an impact in our community. To echo the words of a recent, highly acclaimed school musical, we fashioned a life for ourselves out of hope and thin air. We've run on fumes on many an occasion, and when we ran out of those fumes, we leaned on one another. On our support systems in this very audience, faculty, parents, siblings, to carry forward. And we're here. It's that day. A day of equal parts reflection and progress, an anchoring point that we are supposed to remember for years to come. I'll never forget the words of one of the faculty members here who once told me, and I apologize for the paraphrasing, that the person you are today is the person you once looked up to. Let that sink in for a moment. The person you are today is the person you once looked up to. That future you once envisioned in your mind is here. And it's fitting that as we sit here today, overheating underneath these caps and gowns, that we recognize that little time traveler who dared to dream, to risk, to question, to seek, to fail, to love. Thank that person, that version of yourself, for making you who you are. Recognize that what you're feeling right now, that aspiration, that utter terror, that sense of boundless possibility, that self-doubt, is proof that your mind possesses a power that even time itself can't hold back. Congratulations to the class of 2021, my best friends and future rulers of the world. It's been a privilege being your class speaker. Thank you.
In the upper school ceremony video, we recognize many students for demonstrating excellence in a variety of areas during this past year. At commencement, we show our appreciation for the generosity and vision of the Cary Academy's founders by presenting a special award. The Founders Award is presented to a member of the senior class who, in the opinion of the faculty and head of school, has acted as a model for all Cary Academy students through leadership, collaboration, excellence, and contribution to the school community. This year's Founders Award recipient is Charisma Personified, a young man who radiates genuine warmth and an abiding interest in others. Quote, he shines with an obvious goodness, unquote, says a faculty member. Quote, people gravitate to him because of his kindness, adds another. In the classroom, he is the sought-after collaborator because he cares about his peers as much as he cares about his learning. An outstanding student, he has distinguished himself across every discipline, from chemistry to Spanish, not only for his intellect, but even more for his genuine desire to grow. No one is more invested, more willing to reflect deeply on process, to set high standards for self-improvement, and in doing so, he elevates others along the way. He graces countless groups with his authentic engagement and inclusive nature. Indeed, he has a gift for giving of himself while imbuing others with a sense of belonging, of being a part of things. Beyond his own extensive volunteering with Cur Americas Global, he helped involve the entire upper school community with a gratitude project. In addition to captaining varsity tennis and playing in our top spot, he helped coach the JV girls team. He shares his impressive vocal talents through numerous musicals, choirs, and recently the variety show. He brought us into the circle of Indian culture with his demonstrations of Carnatic music and how to cook Alutiki Chaat. Committed to creating a space for empathy and for diverse voices to be heard, he became a certified Dialogue Across Difference facilitator and joined the board of Coexist. He emerges as a leader and spokesperson in any group he joins, from CA Singers to Science Olympiad. As a sophomore during our 2018 TEDx event, he presented a talk titled, Got Time? Our Endless Pursuit of an Elusive Treasure. It would seem he has found an endless abundance of it. Each year he has taken on more, given more. He is a ubiquitous force for good. Ms. Kakari, would you please join me as it is a pleasure to present the 2021 Founders Award to Vibhav Nandagiri.
Thank you. I got lost in recognizing our outstanding student there. It's my turn to speak. And it's my pleasure to introduce our commencement speaker today. I am honored to introduce our commencement speaker and one of Cary Academy's most ardent and longtime champions, Sandra Gutierrez. Sandra was born in the United States but grew up in Latin America. There she developed a passion for Latin American cuisine that has inspired a long and varied career in culinary arts. As accomplished culinary expert, professional cooking instructor, food editor and writer, and cookbook author, in 1996, she discovered a culinary movement in the United States, one that blends the culinary foodways of Latin America with those of the regional southern United States. She was honored for her efforts with a permanent installation in the food exhibit of the Smithsonian Museum of American History, where her story and few of her personal objects are now featured next to Julia Child's. Sandra is the author of numerous cookbooks, including The New Southern Latino Table, Latin American Street Food, Empanadas, The Handheld Pies of Latin America, and Beans and Field Peas. She has served as food editor of the Cary News and penned thousands of articles that have graced the pages of local, national, and international publications, including USA Today, Fox Latino, Southern Living, Eating Well, Food and Wine, Better Homes and Gardens, and more. A sought-after professional instructor, she teaches cooking classes for various institutions around the country and has been featured on numerous television and radio shows. Sandra's connection to Cary Academy extends back to the very beginning of the early days. When inspired by the promise of vision of new technology forward, inclusive, innovative, student-centered school, she made a leap of faith, enrolling her daughter, Alessandra, as a member of Cary Academy's very first class of sixth graders, the class of 2004. Later, her daughter, Nicole, would join her sister as a member of the class of 2006. A firm believer in Cary Academy's mission, Sandra has shared her extensive expertise, vision, and passion with her community for over a decade as a member of her board of directors from 2008 to 2021. On the board, she served in a variety of capacities, including working on the advancement, equity and inclusion, and governance and nominations committees. Her commitment and voice have been instrumental in helping shape Cary Academy's past and present and have positioned us well for the future, which the class of 2021 looks to now. Please join me in welcoming Sandra Gutierrez.
Dear Dr. Earnhardt, dear Chair of the Board of Directors, dear founders, members of the boards of directors, parents, grandparents, faculty, staff, guests, and graduates of the class of 2021. It is a great honor to be here today as we celebrate this inspiring group of students who are about to complete their educational journey at Cary Academy. Just a few minutes ago, I had the pleasure to meet the class of 2021 and spend some time with them. And I am very impressed by their level of maturity, compassion, and resilience. Here is a group of young people who, despite having gone through the year of a historic pandemic, have done so with aplomb, courage, and with a level of tenacity that sees them graduating successfully and moving forward on their paths toward their professional and personal futures. When I asked a few members of our esteemed faculty to describe some of the accomplishments of the class of 2021, they related that despite the interruption of normal school life, you, the students, not only continued to learn, but also managed to put on a musical, competed in sports, created art, wrote in newspapers, led clubs, catapulted affinity groups and dialogues to bridge racism and social issues, and did this all while supporting each other's efforts and while respecting the diversity of our school community. That is a tremendous accomplishment. For this and more, we celebrate you, the class of 2021. I am an old friend to Cary Academy, a parent to alumni, and a retiring member of your board of directors after 12 years. I am a firm believer in the mission of discovery, innovation, collaboration, and excellence of our school. And do forgive me if I consider Cary Academy a little bit mine too, because Cary Academy has been a very important part of my family. In fact, when I told my daughters I'd be speaking to you today, one of them said, "Mom, finally, it only took you 25 years to graduate Cary Academy." Back in 1996, even before tractors broke ground and worked at light speed to create the first buildings that would become our school, a few parents like my husband Luis and myself believed in the promise of a school in which humanities, math, science, art, engineering, languages, and sports would play a part in an education geared for the whole student. A place where technology would be first class and where our children would thrive as free-thinking individuals that would help them succeed in a competitive career environment. 25 years ago, this place where we stand right now was just a pile of red clay. There was no campus. There wasn't even a classroom. But the vision of our founders, Dr. Jim Goodnight, Ann Goodnight, John Saul, and Ginger Saul, was clear and deeply inspiring. And that was enough for us to take the leap of faith. Today, Cary Academy has met and far surpassed all of their promises. For you, parents, grandparents, and mentors here today, who wonder if your investment has been a good one, let me assure you, it has. Speaking as one who has just completed a position on the board of directors, I can tell you that the group of individuals on your board not only care for each one of your students, but also know each pulse that motors the heartbeat of this school. Together, we've made it a point to foster an environment in which each member of the Cary Academy community can feel safe, respected, welcomed, challenged, and empowered so that each one of them can have all of the elements needed to succeed in their careers. Your board believes that Cary Academy is a place where students can thrive under the tutelage of exemplary faculty that encourages learning by fostering independent research, freedom of thought, open discourse, and respectful debate. A place where all students can become good world citizens, not by being forced to serve, but by discovering the joy of serving others. A place where a code of conduct that teaches respect, compassion, and consequences for actions taken can help them grow into ethical adults. Your kids are prepared to face the future, to construct change, and to build upon the choices that have shaped their world without a need to cancel history, but by learning from it. Cary Academy is an oasis of knowledge that has prepared its students for the real world. One need only look back to the past to see the future that awaits your children. The seeds of curiosity, learning, ethics, collaboration, and love of diversity gathered on this campus will be sowed by each of your graduates wherever life takes them. In case you're wondering where Cary Academy led our daughters, let me share with you that Alessandra, class of 2004, is a thriving dentist in Charlotte, and that Nicole, class of 2006, is a successful lawyer in the Supreme Court of North Carolina. Graduates, Cary Academy has prepared you and you to be leaders, not followers. Within the halls of this learning institution, you have been encouraged to think, to search, and to find your own answers, and not to follow mantras blindly. You have learned to question both knowledge and authority with intelligence, responsible caution, courage, and also with respect and eloquence. Now that you have found your voices, don't lose them. You see, not much is required when one is simply destined to be part of a crowd, but everything is required of those who are destined to lead. And I believe you are preparing for the very important role of leading our country and our world into a better path, just like I just told you a few minutes ago when we were together. Whether you are on your way to become a doctor who will save lives, an engineer who will discover new technology that will feed the world, a writer who will defend freedom of speech, or a teacher who will inspire future generations of students like you, who search fearlessly to make a better world. For this reason, I'd like you to permit me to give you a few words of wisdom and a little bit of inspiration. Always question. If you don't change your mind on something at least once, you haven't looked far enough for the answer. Recognize that leaders most often make decisions that do not always win popularity contests. Therefore, empower yourselves to build your own paths and do not put your lives up to a vote where others get the power to decide for you. Once you leave Cary Academy, don't feel that you need to be perfect. Don't be afraid to make mistakes, but always be ready to face them and correct those mistakes. That's when they become lifelong lessons. If life tells you no, don't take it as a final answer, but rather as a not now, not here, not yet. Because you never know what the obstacles you're having to leap over today are preparing you for tomorrow. Follow your dreams. I know you've heard this before. It's important. Follow your dreams. If someone tells you that you can't do something you believe in your heart you must do, quietly smile and say, "Watch me." Be a maverick. Don't be afraid to stand out from the crowd. In a world where equity and equality are often confused and where everyone wants to box us together into a herd, dare to be different. Because no one is exactly the same as you are, but each one of you is just right the way you are. Think about your time here at Cary Academy. You got as much as you gave. Everything you accomplished, you've earned. I am successful today because I worked hard, gave it all I had to give, my soul, my life to my career. I turned my career into a vocation, not a job. So I tell you, find your vocation. Because a friend once told me, do what you love and the success will follow. So don't be afraid to stick out like a sore thumb from among the crowd. But do it by excelling, by being good at what you do, by being kind and strong valued. Look for the truth, even if that means that you're going to feel very uncomfortable at times. Truth will be your best ally going forward. And don't let yourself be carried by the tide as part of a multitude. Instead, become the wave that guides a tide so others can be inspired by you. That's what leaders do. Don't let anyone try to cancel you because you're different. As a food writer, let me share a recipe for you. I hope you'll write it down. A soup made with only water and salt is bland, even if you're using the most crystal clear water and the salt of the earth. It will only taste like water and salt. but add to it different ingredients, and you'll end up with robust flavor. That, my friends, is to truly love diversity. As you go into your life journeys, remember your teachers, the faculty here who are all part of your success. Write to them. Perhaps remember to send them an email, letting them know how you're doing in college. You will fill their hearts more than you know, and will remind them why they do what they do. As you get ready to leave home, actively nurture your relationship with your parents. And once you're gone, call your parents once in a while. But not only when you need money or when you fail the test. They will, of course, be there for those moments always and will suffer them alongside you. What I mean is, call them for the good things too. When you get a wonderful grade, the day you discover a beautiful spot on campus that made you happy to be there, relate to them those inspiring conversations you have with your mentors, a fun moment you shared with a peer. Because your parents also need to hear the good things. It's what will help them through the times when they'll miss you around the dinner table, or when they will have to sign another tuition check. It's also what will grow your relationship to one, from one adult to the other. Finally, have fun. If there's anything we learned this year, is that life will throw us difficult curveballs. So live without regrets, so that when you are in my shoes one day, giving words of advice to the next generation, you can say to yourself, mission accomplished, and I had the time of my life. Congratulations, class of 2021. Thank you.
Sandra, thank you so much for your inspirational remarks. And now would Palmer Seeley, senior class grade leader, and Ms. Kakari please come forward to assist with the presentation of the diplomas.
Members of the board, faculty, staff, administration, and guests, it is my privilege to present to you the following members of the senior class. They have met all the requirements to earn the Cary Academy diploma. Seniors, when your name is called, please come forward to receive your diploma. Would the seniors on my right please rise? Hannah Caroline Ackman. Arnav Ahuja. Iran Ilker Akil. Sophia Anissa Alvi. Ryan Carter Azrak. Griffin Isaac Baird. Jalen Ruth Berry. Evelyn Rose Brundage. Russell Allen Burns. Hayden Elizabeth Cagle. Reagan Claire Kennedy. Yeah. Casey Allen Cervenka. Catherine E. Chow. Naya Olivia Chavla. Angelina Yinghua Chen. Ryan J. Chen. Sanjana Ram Chilarege. Grace Muksong Chow. Samuel Grayson Corky. In absentia, Wyatt Samuel Courts. Matthew Edward Crow. Jordan Gabrielle Cuffey. Arielle Elizabeth Curtis. Sadie Catherine Daly. Xavier Simon William D'Souza. Tope Daiwin Zhu. Kenneth Edward Amon III. Phoebe Ann Lovejoy Ellison. Mary Eva Esposito. Landon Tucker Evans. Max Felou Merthe. Lauren Reese Ferguson. Claire Elise Ferris. Colin James Fleming. Evan Corcoran Flynn. Thomas Vincent Boachuk Frank. Sarah Susan George. Natalia Hope Ginsburg. Hannah Rebecca Gordon. Paige Haley Gozen. Chloe Holman Griffin. Sarah Margaret Hallman. Eva Sarah Hammer. William Roger Harris. Alan Wong He. Samantha Claire Hoffman. Ethan Elliott Hortolano. Paul Joseph Ibrahim. Tucker Leonard Irwin. Myla Aaron James. Armita Anna Jamshidi. Shannon Kelly Jenkins. Victoria Jasmine Jin. Koa Gustav Kalibi. Lauren Elizabeth Kelly. Would the students on my left please rise? Marvin Burke Kuntz IV. Veronica Kostenko. Christian Michael Larson. Samantha Lake Latanzi. Henry Terrence Lee. Dina Hope Levin. Amy Zhang Liu. Jordan McKay Lucas. Madison Teresa Mackey. Sarah Louise Martin. Lachlan Ellsworth McCallum. Connor Douglas McClanahan. Ellie Claire McMahon. Aaron Michael Messer. Georgia Ann Moorhead. Estella Marie Multari. Kyle Vincent Murphy. Ritvik Nalamothu. Vibhav Nandagiri. Anna Christina Newman. Jackson Scott Nunem. Jacob Isaac Noland. Alton Gwyn Nowell, the fourth. Bryn Elizabeth Oliver. Mila Amit Patel. Luca Franco Pignataro. Abigail Grace Pompeo. Eden Melise Rosenbaum. Anisha Rustogi. Jay Sagrolikar. Nisma Saeed. Priyanshu Saxena. Ryan Alexandra Shafroth. Catherine Slate Shaughnessy. Bela Alamela Shashadri. Jordan Elizabeth Smith. Merav Batsheva Solomon. Sophia Claire Taylor. Nikki Tahi Tehrani. James Claiborne Thornton. Harrison Hood Truscott. Emma Grace Turner. Quinn Evans Vaughn. Maxwell Thomas Von Wy. Elijah Weinstein. Lily Rose Weinstein. Kelsey Elaine Welch. Zachary Benton Wiebe. Lincoln James Willard. Olivia Grace Willard. Philip Franciscus John Wissink. Brandon Tianze Yi. Elena Marie Zayas. Han Zhang. Emily Wei Zhang. Olivia Brock Zimmerman. Would the entire senior class please rise? Ms. Kakare, I hereby present to you the Cary Academy class of 2021. Students, move the tassel from the right to the left.
Graduates, you may be seated. Congratulations, class of 2021. On behalf of Cary Academy Board of Directors, I would like to be the first to welcome you to the Alumni Network. I know you have heard this all year long. Your class will be the most resilient, having gone through this past school year in novel ways. You have shown dedication, endurance, and resolve to make a challenging year most memorable. Despite many obstacles, I appreciate your and your family's commitment to the health and safety of the Cary Academy community. So thank you all. I recently saw a quote that read, "A number two pencil and a dream can take you anywhere." Although after this past year, it may be more appropriate to say, a reliable internet connection, the Cary Academy values of discovery, innovation, collaboration, and excellence, and your grit will take you anywhere you want to go. As you move on to your next endeavors, I hope you keep your Cary Academy family close at heart. Congratulations again, class of 2021.
Congratulations, graduates. It was it's really lovely to see all your smiling faces all together in this venue. I'm so pleased that we were able to do this to end your time at Cary Academy. I'd also like to express my gratitude and the gratitude of the board for everyone who worked so hard to make this ceremony special, and it was a very different ceremony. Michael Hayes, Aaron Yance, Stephanie Dungan, Chris Gilmore, and Allie Page, and the rest of the development team, Jeff Wasensky and our security team, Mandy Daly and the communications staff, Tony Hinton and our facilities staff, and our housekeeping crew from the Bud Group, and of course, Kim Fogelman. They work every year unbelievably hard and behind the scenes to make this ceremony special. But this is a unique ceremony this year, and it's our first outdoor graduation in ages, another first for the class of 2021, so congratulations. And to think a little bit about what Vibhav shared with us, for those of you that are here right now that want to talk about an outdoor graduation in the future, please just check right now how you're feeling, and we'll talk about this a little later. But remember this particular moment in your memory before we talk about an outdoor graduation again. Let me also say to Cary Academy's faculty and staff, there really are no words to do justice to the dedication and sacrifice you have demonstrated in the past year, keeping learning going and our school open. I could not be any prouder to call you colleagues. Thank you. Finally, I would like to recognize any alumni in attendance today. Would you please stand, alum? Thank you for staying connected. We would normally say with your classmates in your school, and in some cases, I would also say with your family. It's been lovely to have you here with us today. Now, as we close, we will wait for our seniors. They're going to process here and then over to the high jump area. And in another first, normally, when we finish the ceremony, the seniors leave outside and they head up to the quad and they toss their caps, and our parents don't get a chance to see that. So in a first this year, we will wait here, they will process over there and they will toss their caps, and you get to witness that particular moment. because of the pandemic and wanting to also respect the fact that many of you are melting at this particular moment, we are going to forego our normal post-ceremony social. You are welcome to linger around, but there are no refreshments. And you'll notice that we've got exits here, we've got exits here, and there's also exits in the back if you need them back there. So with that, I would like to thank you for attending the ceremony for the class of 2021.
Thank you.